Hello and welcome back to Med4Care. Today's topic is the big auto blood transfusion. What do we mean when we talk about big auto blood transfusion? The big auto blood transfusion is a technique of administering ozone therapy, which involves the use of ozone and oxygen. Let's see together, step by step, what are the basic principles of this practice? First, let's understand what ozone therapy is. It is a method of therapy that uses the administration of ozone-based mixtures O3 to treat a large number of ailments and pathologies and promote general well-being. The mixture used has an antibiotic, anti-inflammatory, and pain-relieving action on the body. It's easy to understand that, thanks to these healing properties, ozone therapy is widely used in clinical practice. Well, we have introduced ozone therapy, but do you all know what ozone is? It is a molecule composed of three oxygen atoms. It is produced through an electrolysis process, which breaks down the oxygen molecules O2 and forms ozone. Ozone therapy can be administered in different forms depending on the condition to be treated. The doctor will decide the most suitable modality. Among the most used administration techniques for the introduction of ozone inside the body, we can find injections, insufflation of hollow organs, topical solutions. But today, we focus on the autohemotransfusion. A quantity of blood is drawn from the patient, exposed to the ozone, and then reinfused into the patient. This procedure is used to treat a variety of conditions, including autoimmune diseases, infections, and circulatory problems. Based on the volumes used, it is divided into large and small autohemotransfusions. There are many ways to define this practice of intravenous ozone infusion, which consists of taking blood from a patient, mixing it with ozone, and intravenously reinfusing the blood and ozone mixture. Hence the words that define it. Big, because it uses large volumes of blood. Auto, because it is blood coming from the patient himself. Hemo, because in Greek it means blood. Transfusion, because it is precisely an intravenous infusion. I don't know about you, but I'm very curious to understand how the GAE takes place. It is a sequence of activities. The blood draw. Have you ever donated blood? The procedure is the same. The needle that is placed in the arm is of a valid size to have sufficient blood flow. The blood taken from the vein is collected in a special collection bag, sterile and already prepared with an anticoagulant substance inside. Furthermore, the bag is kept in motion precisely to further prevent coagulation. For this purpose, tilting scales are used which continue to mix the blood during collection. Normally between 100 and 200 milliliters of venous blood are collected, which will then be mixed with ozone and reinfused. After the sampling, it's time for the preparation of the ozone. Once the blood collection is complete, the mixture of ozone and oxygen that will be injected is prepared. The machine that delivers the ozone must produce exactly the amount of ozone required by the doctor's prescription, which varies according to the pathology and conditions of the patient. It starts with pure oxygen, supplied by a dedicated cylinder. The oxygen passes through a circuit that produces electric current and generates the right amount of ozone desired. Once the ozone has been prepared, let's move on to mixing it. The ozone is introduced with a syringe into the bag containing the blood. As the blood and the ozone mix, the blood changes from dark blue to red, a sign of the presence of ozone in the mixture. Mixing is often done directly with the bag placed in the tilting balance, which oscillates gently. It is important in this phase not to forcefully slam the bags to avoid mechanical damage to the red blood cells, which could cause them to break. The last phase consists in the reinfusion of blood and ozone. Without detaching the needle from the patient, the bag with ozonated blood is brought to a higher position with respect to the patient, so that the blood can now descend by gravity and re-enter the circulatory stream. At the end of the infusion, other ancillary drugs are often injected, which enhance the therapeutic effect of the ozone. Vitamin C in high doses, for example, stimulates many metabolic processes, has a preventive effect on cancer, and acts as an antioxidant. Another drug that can be used after ozone infusion is glutathione. It acts in concert with ozone thanks to its important antioxidant, detoxifying, immune system regulating, and cell cycle regulating properties. We have seen all the phases of the treatment, we just have to know how long it can last. A single session of ozone therapy lasts approximately 30 minutes. Treatment with intravenous ozone involves a cycle of sessions, which varies from a minimum of 8 consecutive sessions up to a maximum of 20. The first sessions usually take place on a weekly or bi-weekly basis. Once the cycle is over, it may be useful to carry out treatments to maintain the benefits, usually on a monthly basis. As with any therapy or drug, there are contraindications to big auto blood transfusions. We cannot undergo GAE if we have glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase deficiency. It is a genetic deficiency. If we already have to undergo surgery, that cannot be postponed. If you have a heart failure or a heart attack. If we suffer from clinically manifest hyperthyroidism. If we are pregnant. The time has come to clarify some doubts. Meanwhile, it is legitimate to ask whether the GAE is really effective. If you believe that it is the panacea for all ills, it cannot be so. But there are precise and effective therapeutic indications already known. At this point, a clarification is necessary. Do you know why there is information online about the ineffectiveness of ozone therapy? The web is full of distorted information produced by those who have a specific interest in providing it. In this case, ozone therapy is rather opposed because, not being a traditional drug, it does not allow usual profits related to the drugs. Fake news aside, you're still wondering if GAE is a dangerous procedure. Well, the risks are very low. The procedure is carried out by a doctor or an experienced nurse under the supervision of a doctor who is present for the duration of the treatment. Furthermore, like all therapies, it must be prescribed by a doctor, indicating the motivation, the number of sessions, and the dosage of ozone to be applied. During the preliminary medical examination, the health professional ensures that there are no contraindications to the ozone therapy. One last thing, for those who are afraid of needles, there are alternatives. Alternatively, ozone therapy can also be done rectally. These are insufflations with a tube introduced a few centimeters into the rectum. The doses of ozone used are slightly higher than those used intravenously. The absorption of ozone by the rectal mucosa is variable, therefore it is necessary to calibrate the dosage according to the therapeutic effect obtained in each patient. We have now reached the end of today's video, we hope you enjoyed it. If you found it useful, support us with a nice like, subscribe to the channel, and click on the bell to be notified every time our new video comes out. See you soon on Med4Care.